Hey guys, what's up? It's me, Faye, again, and I am going to do my CD collection, because why not? I have so many, just to warn you, so this video might be a little long. I am going to start with Bring Me the Horizon's album, Sempiternal, which came out in 2013. And this is just like, whatever. And then the tracks, like, they're here in the back, obviously. And it has, since I said I got the deluxe, it has the first CD, which has all the songs, and then it has, shit. But anyways, on this side, I think the other CD has a total of 3 tracks. I thought I had 4. But yeah. I got into them, like, my 8th grade summer, if that makes sense. I was about to be a freshman when I got into them. I think, or 8th grade, 7th grade, I don't know, something like that. And then, again, Bring Me the Horizon, There Is a Hell, Believe Me, I've Seen It, There Is a Heaven, Let's Keep It a Secret. It's a really long album title, but this album is really good. A lot of people didn't really like this album, but I thought it was good. I mean, I like all their albums, and I like all their songs. And on the back, that's how it looks. Yeah. And this one is just, the design is not... I mean, it has, like, you know, the key and then the sword, which is pretty cool. And this one, it came out in 2011 or 10. I think it's 2010. And I also got this one on Hot Topic, but I forgot how much I paid for this one because it's been 6 years already. But yeah, this album is pretty great. If you haven't listened to it and you like Bring Me the Horizon, like, just listen to their songs. Since I've already shown you 2 of Bring Me the Horizon, I am going to show you another one that I have, which is their newest one, that's The Spirit. And it's more simple than, like, as you could tell, it's more simple than most of their previous, like, album designs and album covers. And the inside is very cool. It has, like, this color swirl going on. And then it has an umbrella right here, which is, like, the logo or whatever. And the CD also has the same design going on as the... I really like this album, and I have to say my favorite song from it is Follow You. I just like the way it starts and just the lyrics, everything's, like, great. And then, like, the little book, it has the same, it has an umbrella and it has the same, like, color swirl thing going on, and it has, like, different colors inside, like, with the lyrics and everything, which is pretty cool. I really like I said, I really like all their albums, I like all their songs. I mean, they're a great band. I've seen them live twice and they're so good. Okay. What's the next one? The next one I have is Secrets. And this band is more of, I wouldn't know how to describe them. But I bought the CD at a concert, which is, it's called Screaming Like You Mean It. And they're really nice guys. And I think they only sold it for me for like $10. And on the back it has, like, obviously, like, the tracks, and the design is, you know, kind of weird. It looks like, I don't know, I see them as robots, but I think it's like an industry or something, industrial, like, thing going on. And then since I met the guys, remind you that this CD, if you guys listen to Secrets, remind you that this CD was with the original screamer, which was Alexander, and that guy, like, he was super nice. And yeah, I have pictures with them, but that's how it has all their autographs, and then they even autographed here on the book, and yeah, it's pretty cool. I haven't listened to, like, their newer stuff. I'm still stuck with this album because I like all the songs on it. Okay, and then next I have The Story So Far, and this album is their just self-titled, and I really like this album a lot too. I just haven't listened to it in a while. But I got this one at Target, and I forgot how much it was, but I know it was less than $16. And then in the back, it has, you know, the song type. I mean, the songs. It's like the Bring Me the Horizon album, Sempiternal. And that's basically how it looks. And then again, it has the tracks in the back. And then it's simple. It's just like a navy blue, and then it has, you know, the name of the band right there. It's pretty cool. I'm going to see them this weekend at Warped Tour, so I'm looking forward to that. And then the next one is going to be totally different from what I've shown you so far. And it's going to be Charlie XCX Sucker. Now this album, I started getting into her in 2014, I think. When I saw her perform at the, I think it was the AMAs. I don't know, it was one of those. I liked all the songs, so I bought the album, because why not? And I really like the CD. Everything is pink, and I just like the way it looks. I think it's pretty cool. Next, I have Sum 41, Underclass Hero, and I got this album, I think, when I was in middle school. I got it at a music store, but I forgot the name of it. I think it was Sam Goody or something like that. And this album, okay, first of all, I've been a fan of Sum 41. I was going to say Boomer the Horizon. I've been a fan of Sum 41 ever since I think I was in 7th grade. I was obsessed with this band. I was obsessed with Blink-182, I was obsessed with Green Day, I was obsessed with Avril Lavigne, and it's on Dumb. But yeah, like, so this album is basically like one of my favorites, all-time favorites, and I don't know if I showed the back. But yeah, it's pretty cool. And then I like that it has like a pink like going on and stuff. Like, and then this, I think it came out when he, because Derek Whibley, which is like the lead singer, he was married to Avril Lavigne, and when her album came out, like the Best Damn Thing, it was all pink as well, and like I had a pink thing going on. And I think this album came out like the same year as hers, so I think it's kind of cool how they kind of went with the same kind of, you know, colors and stuff. And I really like the CD, like the designs on it, the pictures. I think it's really badass. Like, I don't know. I'm lame, but yeah, I think it's really cool, and it has like a, I don't know, it's just like a really nice pink. Like, it just looks really cool. And then it has like a fly. Like, I don't know what that symbolizes, but I think it's really awesome. And I really like this picture too. Like, I even tried drawing it when I was in middle school, and I don't know what I did with it, but I drew exactly the same thing. It was really cool. I'm also going to see them this weekend. Okay, so another CD, one of my favorites is Flyleaf's, and it's Memento Mori. I've been listening to Flyleaf since middle school as well, and I really like Lacey Mosley. Like, her voice is just, I think she's one of my favorite female vocals, like, ever. Like, her voice is just amazing. And on the back, you know, the tracks, and the CD, and the book, what, the lyrics and stuff. Oh crap, I forgot to show you guys this one. Bring Me the Horizon, Suicide Season. Oh, like, it's so amazing, like, and everything about it, like, I don't know. But this album, so I have basically all their albums except the first one, which is Count Your Blessings, and I still plan on getting that one. I just haven't found it yet at the store. But best album ever. If you guys hear barking, it's my dog. Okay, and then next I have 5 Seconds of Summer, which was is their first album. And I started listening to them because I started getting into One Direction, and I found out about them because of them. And I got this album at Target. I forgot how much I paid for it again. But yeah, this is how the back looks. And the CD is... Oh crap, I don't remember this. Well, it came with this. I think they're like cards or something, but it has like, you know, their picture and stuff. And it just like says these things, like quotes by them. I don't remember like what month I bought it, but the CD is blue, and it's the deluxe album, which is pretty cool. And I don't know whose hand is that. I think it's Callum. I'm not sure. But yeah, 5 Seconds of Summer. Like, I like their new album also. I just don't listen to them as much anymore. Next, I have Bob Marley and the Wailers. And this album, I love this album also. I like all the songs on it. And I listen to it once in a while. And on the, it has 2 discs, so that's why it has like so many songs. But Yeah. I got this one at Target a while back. I think I was like a sophomore in high school. I don't remember. And that was like... like 4 or 5 years ago. And then the other CD, the second CD, is red. Yeah. And then it has a picture of him smoking weed. And then this one is actually not mine, but I stole it from my mom because I really like his music and his songs. And this is my favorite album by him, and it is Michael Jackson's album Thriller. And as you can tell, it's old. It has like all these scratches. And then it has him, you know, and the Thriller video. CD is just black and gold. It's pretty cool. And I really like this album. And then even the CD is like gold itself. And my favorite song on this one has to be Baby Be Mine, The Girl and The Girl Is Mine. Those are my favorite songs. The next album I have is Paramore's album Riot. This is another band that I grew up listening to when I was in middle school, and I was obsessed with them as well. And yeah, I forgot. I think I bought this one at Walmart when Walmart was cool. And then Riot, yeah, it still smells the same. Like, I know that sounds weird, but I remember it had this smell when I bought it, and it still smells exactly the same. I hardly use it, so. Okay, and then this video is getting really long. And then I have another album by The Story So Far, and it's What You Don't See. And this album is really good besides Under Soil and Dirt. And yeah, same design. And it's just, that's basically how it looks, the CD. It's pretty cool. This band is really good. Like, if you haven't checked them out, you should check them out. My favorite song from here would probably have to be Bad Luck and The Glass. Then I have Never Shout Never. I was more insistent than else. I have Never Shout Never's album, The Sunflower. And I met Christopher Drew at Warped Tour in 2013, so that's his signature. It's kind of weird. But he's so, like, when I met him, I still didn't believe he was real. And it's the same design as, like, the cover as Sunflower. And this album is pretty good. I know a lot of people stopped listening to him after Time Travel, but even though this album is really simple, like the book, this is all it is, but I think it's his own artwork. Like, I think he actually drew this. Cause I remember, like, he would post more things on Twitter and Instagram, and I remember him saying, like, oh, which one's best for the album cover, and everybody chose this one. Next, I have One Direction's album, Made in the AM. Oh my god, yes, this album is just everything, and I still love One Direction. I'm always gonna love them. My favorite song, even though I don't have the deluxe one, it is AM. That song, oh my god, like, when I first listened to it, I fell in love with it, and I even bought it on iTunes, just that song, like, not the other ones. I do like all the songs on this album, but AM is my favorite one from the deluxe version. And that's how it looks. It's upside down, so yeah, it looks weird. Really good CD. And then I have One Direction's album 4, and this is the ultimate edition. This is like the yearbook kind of edition. And this one, I still kept this, and it's just like, it's separate from the book. But, and the thing about these is the CD is in here, but the really cool thing about these, it has like pictures, then it has this little thing that they wrote, and then it just has all these other pictures, like Zayn, Harry, Louis, Liam, Niall, like, and then fan art, fan pictures. I think it's really cool. And I haven't told you guys, but Louis and Harry are my favorite ones from One Direction. And no, I do not believe, and I know I'm gonna get hate if one of you guys see this, but no, I do not believe in Larry. I do not believe in that. And the next album I have is This It by The Strokes. And I bought this one recently because I've been listening to them a lot recently. And the back looks kind of, I don't know, every time I see it, it just reminds me of China or something because it looks Asian. And yeah, like I really like the CD the way it looks, because that's like they're basically like their logo or like the way their signature. And on the inside, I don't remember, I forgot if I have, no, it doesn't have lyrics. It just has like pictures of them. And I really like The Strokes a lot. Next I have another CD for my mom, and it's the Pet Shop Boys. And if you haven't heard of this duo, oh my god, like if you like electronic music or like fast music like that, this is the duo. Like you should listen to these people. Like they're just so good. Like West End Girls is obviously like everybody's favorite, and Suburbia is a really good one. Just Heart, like all those songs, like they're just so amazing. And it's very simple. But I mean, you know, this is from the 80s, so it's very simple. Well, I think this one came out in the 90s, but like all these songs is just it's Pet Shop's just I don't know how to pronounce that, discography or discography. And it just has all their hits. And my mom ordered this one from like a catalog kind of thing, because she ordered this like in 2002 or something. I know it was like around the time. And then the next one I have is, I do not listen to them anymore, and I don't listen to their new stuff, but I have Paper and Sirens, kind of like an EP thing. And it's, if you were a movie, this would be your soundtrack. And it's basically just like some of their songs, which is like James Dean and Audrey Hepburn, and they're just slowed down, like, which is really cool. I really like acoustic, so this album, I had to buy it. And the CD is just red and has a name right here, and then it has like a car, and it's pretty cool. Oh my god, this video is super long. Okay, I need to hurry up. And then the main, I don't listen to them, but my friend lent me this and I forgot to get it back, and yeah, I kept it. And it's Pioneer, and I've seen them live, they're pretty good. And yeah, that's how it looks. Next, I have the Beatles, and my grandpa got me this from the flea market, and it's just like all their hits. Okay, I keep hearing the car, but yeah, like it just looks like that. And then these aren't really CDs, but I have a Mod Sons EP, Happy As, you know, Happy As F. And I met him also, and he signed it for me. Well, my friend bought me it, and he signed it for me, and it says my name. And then I have they give this to like at music festivals like Warped Tour and NSN, and it is Victory Records, and it's the Spring Rock sampler, and I forgot what year I got this, but I have like two of them. I think I got this one at Warped Tour, or I don't know if it was this one. I think it was, this is the one from Warped Tour, because this is summer 2013, so it was this one. And it just has bands like Tear Out the Heart, Snow White's Poison Bite, The Bunny and the Bear. And on this one, it has Seeker, Terror, Counterparts, A Day to Remember, Emir, Comeback Kid, Bunny the Bear. And Free Stuff is always the best, right? And then this group, I don't know if they're like a band or a group, but I met them and I saw them at Warped Tour, and they were really nice guys, and they gave me this for free. They're called New Beat Fun. I don't know if they have any other albums because I didn't keep up with them, but that's basically how it looks. They're like pop. And then I have Warped Tour 2013, the tour compilation, and it has Dreaming the Rise and Oliver Sykes in the front. And it just has a bunch of artists. It has two discs, and Well, that's pretty much it, guys. This video is super long. Sorry if it's really long. Like, I know long videos, a lot of people don't like looking up, like, even want to, like, check them out because they think they're boring. But I couldn't make it any shorter because, you know, these are all the CDs I have, and I want to talk a little bit about them and where I got them at. But anyways, I'll try to make more videos, I hope, because, I mean, there's nothing much for me to talk about, but I would try to come up with ideas. And if you guys are having a crappy day, I hope this video, like, made you want to buy a CD or made you want to listen to some of these bands, artists. So thank you for watching, and if you haven't, subscribe and like this video, and bye, guys.